Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Neural Cloud on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Neural Cloud and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Neural Cloud. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, to get started we have to open our main web browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL that I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. There is no need to type it, because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our website of Usitility, exactly where we find here a detailed description on the best way to download and install Neural Cloud on PC. We browse down a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Neural Cloud on the PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of pros of preferring using that emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the Neural Cloud by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on the button, and the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file to execute. What we are going to do is to launch the installer. Okay, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the computer. We said yes. I reduced the browser to see the installer significantly better. The installer is quite simple. It consists of two choices, install and setup path. I will clarify what setup path does. We basically just simply click on it. Therefore we see that we get here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we desire to change this folder we are required to click on the browse option, and we decide on another folder and set up the emulator wherever we wish. I will set it where it is. I simply click back, so I click on install. Voila! The installation starts and it's going to move forward in the download of these megabytes that happens to be visible on the computer screen. When you save it on your computer, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, determined by your type of access to the web and depending on the performance of the emulator servers. Right now they are running superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been launched immediately. As you will notice, down here, there is a progress bar that will advance to the right and once it gets to the end, the emulator is started for the first time. The fact is the emulator has already been launched, here for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can discover, it has created two software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the only one we are concerned about. Whenever we have to start Neural Cloud on the desktop or laptop, we double-click that app icon and therefore run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should do the next step, that is a requirement, and this is to entry the Google Play Store. And we will click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is launched. Here we must sign in. At present when we are there, we are required to execute the next step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. So we mouse click on sign in. At this point it says checking info. It can in some cases get blocked in checking info. That's why it does not move forward. If that's the case, you can try to log in and after a couple of hours it's going to almost certainly be fixed. At this point we are going to enter our email and password. The email address has to be a Gmail email as well as its associated password. For example, you make use of the same email address you're using at this moment in your YouTube account. Thus, I am going to submit my details and I'll go back as soon as I have completed it. That's all, data entered. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We are going to say yes to them all by clicking, I agree. After that, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You could let it select it and it will create a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play Store is launched by default and immediately. To set up the application, we have to go to the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on this app icon marked green colored. Today that we are on the desktop of the Android emulator, we observe that we find here the install game option. We click or double-click on the button. Right here we have the game. Let's quickly press now on the install button that I'm presenting now in green color. Therefore it will start the installation. At present it should download on your laptop or computer and install the game. It typically takes a bit of time or it may possibly be very fast. That all is subject to on our own connection to the internet. It's actually ended setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this button that I'm emphasizing in green, in order to launch Neural Cloud for the very first time. We're by now on the emulator desktop, then we're about to just click this new Neural Cloud software icon which was created. This game is launched for the first time on your device. Currently there we end up with it. I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume of this emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we could switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the first one. We just click on this particular app icon that I am actually designating in green color. Then the screen is maximized, getting one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Supposing that we desire to appreciate the video game in full screen, we hit this icon. And we might already be experiencing the video game in 100% screen mode. To exit the complete screen functionality, press the F11 key. And therefore we would by now end up being in regular display screen mode. At this moment I am going to reveal you the computer keyboard mapping that is certainly very interesting. That step we will certainly be ready to use the game app far more effortlessly. The very first point is to click this software icon. And here you will be able to make the required adjustments. I'll go ahead and leave the default settings, though if you like to improve it, you may well do this without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our language. Occasionally it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, such as, in Mandarin. Then to set it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here within additional configurations, we just click the language drop down. We could choose the language we need. German, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is decided, we are going to save. The emulator will restart, along with the video game. Next time we use it, will of course be in the selected language. At present, there is another aspect that we will need to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email telling you that a different device has been connected with our Google account. It definitely will check with us if we're the people who have connected that device. Yup, we really should not be troubled, considering the fact that emulator is emulating an Android electronic device. And then to see which device is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. So we go here to the model option. And right here we notice that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the training. I believe you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was interesting. If that's the case, bring it a good thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any remarks, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment area down below. You could possibly also leave a comment on my Twitch channel. I perform live streams every once in a while. You have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Check out any of these videos which are usually showing up on the computer screen and see you in the future online videos. Bye.